How many seasons is this, babe?
EA Sports. It's in the game.
How many seasons?
Slide trying to bend the corner of your limbs, game. That's your partner, then you're twinking. All you want to do is talk, I don't need talk.
Is this a match? Is it a match on anything you watch? Why isn't he letting her go? It's like he's supposed to probably kill her.
I thought I told you names, we are not the same. Shitty, shitty, bang, shitty. them cannons rain. Make sure you fold already when you see the game. I thought I told you lames, we are not the same.
I'm ready for more. If you fired up, I'm fired up. Don't run from red.
Oh.
1, 2, 3. Hey. I'm ready for more. Tell him I'm ready for yes. War. Game time.
Like,
I'm ready. Ready for war.
Yes.
Tell him I'm ready for war. I just got 20, I'm running on empty. This mobile that came from my money is silly. I feel like envy, not trying to be friendly. It is what it is, if you want me, come get me. Whenever you ready, no, I keep it steady. I get the W, throw the confetti. Please do not tip me, don't hold it against me. We about that action, don't ever forget it. Why the gorillas, the army, the navy? I call a play, I'ma score like I'm Brady. The title is mine, if you want it, come take. I'm ready for more. Tell them I'm ready for more. I'm ready for war. Tell them I'm ready for war.
What, the girl that that guy has? Oh, that's who she's calling about? Oh, shit. And she has a kid?
Salute when you see me. That G
jealousy is an ocean, and you either float or you sink. Moment of truth, credit check. You not a fool, BB King. I'm in love with the blues. Don't start me up, I got finishing moves. Look, salute when you see me. Slid through all the commotion, it's breaking news. They got an ad on TV. Popping out all of my politics, and probably in a section where you not permitted. My honey's matching my Dodger fitted, playing all gold, ain't no stopping in it. Look, salute when you see me. I bought her a CC, and that was her purse. Disgusting with do for a purse, disgusting with do for the clout. I'm one of the realest, the real ones could vouch. They thought I was done, but all that doubt. You gotta pay my bitch. Salute when you see me. Put in the car to the my runner gets you speed. Still thugging like the days when they weren't here in my CD. Made it out of the trenches. Just salute when you see me.
Yeah.
Salute when you see me.
I'm getting greedy. I blow the whole budget on me. That's on me. I'm conceited. Treaty. Nah, that ain't how we treat it. This right here sound like a three-peat. I put the dip in it, sound like I'm knee-deep. I'm like, oh, you too needy. Me and HB going to me and BG. They gotta put my face on the box of Wheaties. I'm praying for whoever think they compete. So when you see me, that's all he ever, so that's how you greet me. I'm going TM-101, cheesy, and Pussy got DC on repeat. I'm with the love of my life for like 3 weeks, cause that's all I needed. She wanna go on a trip or retreat, but I'm sorry, I never retreated. I set the bar so high that you might as well leave it. I'm going undefeated, I'm broken the system. Had to breach it, that mission impossible, mission completed.
Salute when you see me.
Yeah, I got the heart of a god and a genie. I want you to love me, I want you to need me. When I this face is vegan, I gotta get back to the hood. I remember when I was the needy. Clean me up. She fell in love, deeply, sleepy. They like when I say they repeat me. Look, all this money I be spending on BBs. That's why you gotta see when you see me.
Started from the gutter. Started like no one stunned. She curved back then, came back, so I swung. ain't going out like no sucker. Had to let it burn like Usher. Gave a rush for an hour, Chris Tucker. You cannot mistake me for another. I had to wait my time like a buffer. I'm that did I stutter. Ball hard, might get a tick. Bought a push start for it, got a check. Drip too hard, made a... I know she won't forget that we met. She hit her, broke her down, she a wreck. They saying, Mo, you better than the rest. Who, me? I never would've guessed. Rookie, but I do it like a vet.
I like cash money, yeah, baby, I'm a stunner. I'm a boss, I can do what I wanna. Your last was a dude, boy, that wasn't running. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. Shot up to the moon, we ain't never going under. Hit someone, hit some old town slugger. Why after why, we ain't never got a suffer. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. I like cash money, yeah, baby, I'm a stunner. I'm a boss, I can do what I wanna. Your last was a dude, boy, that wasn't running. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. Shot up to the moon, we ain't never going under.
Some my old town slugger way out the way. She's a pickpocket. People like that, they could just walk up on you and just grab your wallet without you even knowing. Yeah, she's smooth like that. They can walk up on you, bump you, fucking get all in you. I'm talking about you can have your shit all in here. Yeah, you can have it all in you. All in underneath and shit. And they still get that shit. Gotta watch out for people like that. Bump you and shit. Stand next to you.
Hey, Jeff.
Shot up to the moon, we ain't never going under.
Thank you.
nobody help when I was hungry. Fake friends, they just slipping away. Now I got it, so I ball.
Oh, she came back with the tote bag? So she didn't leave him? So she didn't leave him out there?
To email the venues and ask them if I could be opening act for the rappers that's passing through town. I used to be the one kids in my city was laughing about. I used to envision everything happening now. I used to ride the bus and listen to Kendrick Lamar. He just liked the video that I made back when I started to study his bars. I like to think that he probably related to someone that's come so far, to someone that wanted it badly, then when it got it and turned to a star. Overly dedicated, a title that resonated. I wanna be recognized, I wanna be decorated. Truthfully, back then I couldn't imagine a life where I never made it. Go ahead and let him hate it. Let him hate it.
I ain't never had no money. I've been out here trying to give me away. Ain't nobody helping, I was hungry. Fake friends, they just slipping away. Now I got it, so I ball.
even hungry, but I ate that. I keep on winning and they hate that. And they hate that. And they hate that. I ain't even hungry, but I ate that. I keep on winning and they hate that. And they hate that. And they hate that.
Eat them up. If I don't do nothing, I serve. Really, I'm super absurd. Got them all dead like birds. Leave a speechless, no words. Leave a speechless, no. Coming in first, who's third? Tight fit, showing my. Lights, camera, action like verbs.
Going hard for my sisters. Hurry up, take my picture. Heels hurt, I got blisters. Touchdown, make me richer.
Playoff football has come to the west coast of Florida, and we are at Raymond James Stadium here in Tampa. Ahead, we'll decide the second entrant to next week's NFC title game, as we've got a great one in store between the Minnesota Vikings and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Championship round. We'll know soon enough as we are underway here on a January afternoon.
Here we go. Here we go. Here we go.
Cousins on first down. And this turns into a nice gain with a slide at the end.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
A former Seminole back home in Florida, it's Dalvin Cook. And he stopped immediately there. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down.
Good job there to locate his tight end, Charles, in the middle of the field.
Yeah, he has good pass-catching abilities, and if they're able to continue to find him here in the early going, I think it'll help out his teammates out on the perimeter. You can take the big shots later if he occupies their attention.
2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know. You know better than I. He has the ability to take over a game, so what do you do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels, because if you crowd everyone to the line of scrimmage, if he breaks through, it's nothing but room to run.
And that falls to the ground, incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively, and now it brings up third down. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. To throw is Cousins.
To the right side, and complete to Jefferson.
And he will have a Vikings first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Well, I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
Now a throw here to his running back. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game.
I like it, I like it, I like it. Get everyone involved in the passing game, and you know you can create those great mismatches throwing it to your guys out of the backfield.
And on the first drive, that can also help establish some rhythm, right?
I think so. It gets everyone involved. They feel like they're part of it, and really gets them amped up as they go forward.
They'll say no gain on the play, so it was looking good, but nothing there. Now it's third down and inches. They'll run it. Here's Cook. And he's got the first as they'll bring him down at the 28-yard line.
had a chance to maybe limit them to three if they could have gotten that stop there, but a new set of downs.
And with a new set of downs, you got to take the mentality of the whole thing. Right now, everyone's looking at the offense and saying they've got the advantage.
Under pressure, and down he goes. They sack him back at the 36. Devin White, it'll go as a loss of about eight as he gets in there to drop him. So second and long, and got to be careful not to fall out of field goal range. Another try after the first down sack. Cousins swinging this out wide here for Cook. And that's good for a gain of six. And that's going to lead to a third and 11. And they're getting him involved early.
You feel like they saw something on tape, or they just have a sense with him because he's had a good week of practice or something in that area, that they want him involved. Just as you said, they want him to touch it either in the running game or the passing game, but they must like the matchups they're getting.
And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. From the red zone now, Cousins. And it's incomplete. Boy, he doesn't drop many like that one. Second down.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
On second down now, it's Cook looking to find a lane, but he can't rein in at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the run there, and now they'll be looking at a third down. So a third and 10, and defensively, a dime look, six DBs. Working out of the gun, Cousins. Now the hit comes, and Cousins lost the football. And it's picked up by the Buccaneers. And his guys are going to get the football at the 23-yard line. A bad third down mistake there.
Points were already on the board in their mind. And that's the worst part about it, right? Because it's just like in golf. Never count it in the cup until it rolls in there. Otherwise, you can really get messed up with your scores. In this case, you know they thought, hey, at least three, maybe even a chance to get six. It's a little bit demoralizing going off the field now that you've turned it over and you come up empty.
Yeah, if he holds on to that, at least the field goal on fourth down, now they lose it. On the ground, this is Leonard Fournette. And he is going to wind up losing yardage here, as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. An extra defender in the secondary for the Vikings here on third down. To throw is Brady. Open man, that's Noah Fant, the tight end. And he'll go out near midfield at the 49. Fournette, a first down carry. And he'll manage to pick up about four. It's second down.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown, so a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later, and let's face it, you could do worse than a four-yard run on first down.
Oh, not sure he saw the linebacker there, as that's batted down and incomplete.
And that's a nice job there, because you've got to play the ball, not the man when in coverage. That'll keep you away from a lot of needless penalties, and he's able to knock that one away.
Throwing is Brady on third down. That is taken in by the tight end, Finn. Touchdown, Tampa Bay! Noah Finn, 47 yards. And the Bucs are on the board first here in this division round matchup. Extra point put through by Succum, and it's now a 7-0 game. It's Ryan Succop on after the touchdown to kick it away. Kenny Nwangu now out of his end zone. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And they'll be looking to atone for last time's mistake of fumbling inside the red zone. Certainly they don't want to do that again.
And so much emphasis placed on red zone offense. I mean, you have periods devoted in practice just for that, because everyone knows how vital it is to put points on the board when you've entered that part of the field. And to come away with nothing, that's difficult for a team to handle.
Yeah, difficult, and now we'll see if they can make it less difficult on themselves on this drive. First down, here's the run with Cook. And he's able to get across midfield and down into Buccaneer territory. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down. 2 minutes gone by, second quarter. Second down, they go right back to Cook. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41.
Second and one, if people want to run the football, this is where every back in the league is supposed to do exactly what we just saw there, pick up the first down.
First down, here's Cousins. That's caught by the tight end, Irv Smith Jr. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25.
I know I spent a lot of time talking about how tight ends in a lot of cases now are pumped up wide receivers, but they're still big people. He used that frame right there to absorb a really big hit on him and held on to the ball.
On first and 10, Cousins. He'll dump this off to Cook. Down he goes at the 23, a pickup of 4. Looking to throw again on second down. Cousins. And this throw incomplete. Now the defender all over him that time, and it's going to lead to third down.
Normally you think the tight end's going to be able to catch the football and handle that contact, but in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well. Incomplete.
That's to Cook out of the backfield. And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. 3 yards, all they could muster there, and it'll bring up fourth down.
How about that strategy there, Brandon? Third down, they just said, we've got faith in our tackles. We'll give you the short stuff, and just decided to protect the sticks. So every time I hear fans telling me tackling's not a part of the game anymore, plays like that, I can clip and save and show them you have to tackle well if you want to be a good defense.
So from an offensive perspective, at least able to get on the board here right in front of the 2 minute warning.
Yeah, now it's time to talk about complimentary football, isn't it? Because if the defense can force a three and out, there could be enough time on the clock that they can get the ball back for their offensive guys and maybe put some more points on the board before the half.
Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Did they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it up.
Breaks the tackle, he's got room to run. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A big play that time on the catch and run. And CD, we have seen some great runs the last few times we've been together, but I think we could at least put this one in our top five. That was a determined gallop there. We remind you, as we've done all year, that coming up at halftime, we will visit with Jonathan Coachman, standing by at Orlando. He'll let you know what's going on here on a very eventful. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 30. And his guys will take over at the 30-yard line. So first and 10 now from the 30. Following the interception, Cousins. And complete right side to Cook. And he's brought down at the 34. Call it a gain of 4. They go play action. Cousins. Open here, Adam Thielen. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Cousins gives way to Cook. He won't find a ton of space following the display of power as he's down just inside the 45. On second and 9, Cousins throwing the out route incomplete. That's Smith. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take what you can get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now gives him a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
Third and short yardage, Cousins. Here's Johnson with a reception. And this is going to lead to another first down as the tackle's made at the Bucs 14. Back to the ground, Cook. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. The Vikings going to signal for the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Cousins. And he'll find Thielen on the right side. Now the Vikings will use the second of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. Now Cousins. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
These guys had to settle for a field goal their last time moving the ball down the field. They may have to do it again on this drive. That could be frustrating.
Yeah, I don't want to be cliche, but at least they were able to get three last time. Three here, not the worst thing in the world. Mike Zimmer's made his decision, and that decision is to try and go for this thing on fourth down. They'll run for it. Cook. And he won't have the touchdown, but he will have the first down as he's tackled at the two. From the shotgun, it's Cousins. That's into a crowd and intercepted. Picked by Pierre Desir. And now look at him go. 30, 20. And it's a pick six. He brings it back to the house for Buccaneer TD. We'll see if that pick six looms large as this game continues, because we've seen plays like that alter a lot of playoff contests over the years.
I would agree with that totally, and you often think to yourself, why do they alter it so much? Because after games, don't we hear coaches and players say, well, one play doesn't usually determine the outcome? But I don't think that's really true to you, because there's times when you see plays like that, and all of a sudden the momentum jumps to that team side, it deflates the other side, and they never pick it back up. Then things really go from there, don't they?
That's the thing for me. We talk about momentum changes. A play like that is the ultimate momentum change. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. Nwangu now from his end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And with 8 seconds on the clock, really not a lot of time to try to put anything together. A nice burst there as they'll get about 7 that time on the first down run. So we've come upon halftime here in this NFC divisional round matchup. As we send you a stone's throw away across I-4 to Orlando, there standing by is Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. A trip to the NFC title game hanging in the balance. Second half action back underway. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Brady going to bring the Bucs up with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Throwing to start the drive. Brady. And this will be well too low for him to bring in. It's incomplete.
They certainly thought they had him surrounded and probably thought they were going to get him on the ground and get the sack, but he's able to elude that. And even though it threw it incomplete downfield, if you're a defensive back, you're loving the pressure that you're seeing from your front.
Meanwhile, Brady's throw on target to Godwin here. He'll be dropped after a gain of about 6 across the 30 to the 31. From the gun on third down, Brady. It's caught by Mike Evans. And he is down deep into Minnesota territory. A big play.
play that time for Tampa Bay.
Well, fair to say that when you're looking at guys that can run like the wind, you often find them at the wide receiver position, and that was special there.
Running left, it's Fournette. And he'll be stopped after a gain of only a couple down to the 15-yard line. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
Throwing on second and eight, Brady. He's going to drop this one down to Bernard. So give him 5 yards there on the pitch and catch. And that's going to bring up a third down.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get out to your running back and it can turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short gain.
Working from the gun, it's Brady. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete.
And the Buccaneers are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points.
Bernard. And this will result in him losing yardage back to the three. Now that sends him 2 yards in the wrong direction and leads to second down. Fournette. And he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the five. It'll go down as a 2 yard loss, and it brings up a third down. The defense was ready for the run pass option, diagnosed it perfectly.
Not only did they stack him up at the point of attack, but he was met by a host of light colored jerseys.
Brady now on third and goal. Eluding the pressure right toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. This Minnesota D up to the task on the third down pass play. Suckup's kick is good, and they will stretch the lead down to 17-3. So put another three on the board. All things considered, a good opening drive to begin the third quarter.
That is defense. The way that this game is going, you're excited to see those points go on the board. Gives them a little bit of leeway to play with when they're out on the field, but they're real excited to see their offense score. Now they get to go out there and do their part.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And their deficit a little wider now than it was at halftime following the field goal a moment ago.
But the goal is still the same because you know they want to come out, establish a rhythm in the second half, and get going. Make no mistake about it, though. Kicking field goals, not in their game plan. They need to get the ball in the end zone.
A first down throw for Cousins. Let's it fly for Thielen. And this one is incomplete.
But the passing windows are just not there. That's just another example of how great this defense has been all game long.
And that's exactly what a top 10 defense can do. They can really change the game tempo and frustrate you as you try to execute offensively.
On second down, Cook. And this winds up a gain of 4 to the 41.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get them into a manageable third down because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
On third down, Cousins. And this is going to be incomplete.
He's had trouble finding open receivers all game, CD, and that's because really there hasn't been any. This defense has been all over them.
Yeah, they're one of the better defenses in the league, and every time I talk to someone around the NFL, they all say the exact same thing. They're so fundamentally sound, it's hard to execute against them.
I guess they figure they got to start taking some chances. Here's a big one in this third quarter.
as he'll go for it on fourth down. Open man is Thielen. It's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. Cousins to throw it. Swinging this out wide here for Cook. And he'll get it down here to the 43. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues.
Now the hit comes, and Cousins lost the football. Fortunate to get that football back, because trailing here in the second half, last thing they needed was to lose the possession.
And the word I think of here is opportunity, because it could have been lost there, their chance to score points. But the opportunity for the defense was to go ahead and really close this game down if they were able to get possession.
Cousins now. Open man is Osborne. He's got it. And he can only get this to the 42-yard line, and that is not near enough. One quarter remains for a trip to the NFC title game. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Darren Lee picks it. Past the 20. Five, and it's a pick six. He brings it back to the house for a Buccaneer TD. That's the story of the game. They've been suffocating all game long on defense. They were suffocating there again in a big way.
And they've done it not just by out-athleting them, which is often the case, but by being able to adjust to anything they tried to throw at them and beating them to the punch each and every time. This was a defense that was well prepared.
And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. Their hopes of advancing past this divisional round, hanging by a thread, if that, as they begin here with a first and 10 on the wrong side of the scoreboard. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. They're backed up here with a first and 20 now after the holding penalty. To throw, Cousins. And he's going to be intercepted for the third time thus far. Darren Lee picks it. And he's going to get this on down to the 13-yard line.
From the 13 now, they work on first and 10.
So after the INT, it's Brady. Completes it to Fant on the right side. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. From the 4, this is second down and 1. Fournette running out of the gun. And he's maybe going to get this back to the 4, but that's about all. No gain on the play, and now they're faced with a 3rd and 1. The Bucs on 3rd down. They've been near perfect, 4 for 5 to this point. They need just a yard here. It's 3rd and 1. To throw is Brady. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. Touchdown! Giovanni Bernard from 4 yards out. And the Buccaneers are moving closer to a date now. The NFC Championship game as they're able to extend this fourth quarter lead. Extra point up and good by Succop. And that'll increase their lead to 28. Now it's Ryan Succop on after the touchdown to kick it away.
Nwangu now from his end zone.
Oh, a good-looking return set up here. And a good return, able to get out across the 35 to the 36. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. They knew this would be tough on the road, divisional round, and that has certainly been the case with the deficit they face in this fourth quarter. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here, second down. The last run got a couple here, 2nd and 8. They run it again with Cook. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. The Vikings on 3rd down, not quite 50%, 4 for 9. They're up against a 3rd and 1 situation.
And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Darren Reed picks it.
Talking about making industry music. They want me to cap to y'all, but ain't gon' cap to y'all, cause y'all went up when they ain't had a ball. He talk his body, wonder how he felt watching his dog casket fall. I had to tell my YG stop, he don't like to pass the ball. That ticket, he talking big hit, I was kicking in houses for it. That's two different tickets, right? Oh yeah, they louder, boy. Them players lazy, they don't get no bread. Yeah, they be counting, boy. Them labels scouting, boy. They talking M's only the thousand, boy. I let it get too touch, and it get too foul, boy. I'm talking, you out of bounds, boy. They always screaming, reach be snapping. I say the collar, boy. I'ma lose the roof and the stain. Please don't test me like on that boy, Jenny. And ain't talking game. It's like everything, look, cut them drop. They go insane, they wanna pick. Ain't gon' get in the beef, I'ma just make them blitz. Round four deep in the sprinter. How that's your girl, and she in my rental. We had cables, we ain't even have no tunnels. They change the channel and they see me. I'm signing deals and not no plea. Burglary, B&E. Don't you size me like no rapper. I be quick to grab my ski. That's my sweet, but I be switching it depending on the week. Christian Lou, red bottom, them I think I cut my feet. They talking about making industry music. They want